Welcome to NonstopNeuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will talk about the spread of impulse and excitation-contraction coupling in cardiac muscle. Let's get started. First of all, the impulses for the heartbeat originate in the SA node and then spreads throughout the musculature of the heart. Now let's zoom into the cardiac muscle to understand how it spreads from cell to cell. This is a cardiomyocyte. The invaginations in its membrane are T-tubules. This is the sarcoplasmic reticulum. And these are contractile filaments, actin and myosin. All over the membrane, we have voltage-gated sodium channels and L-type of calcium channels. And on the sarcoplasmic reticulum, there are ryanodine receptor channels, which are also called calcium release channels. This is one cell. Many such cells are connected side by side at intercalated discs. Here, a high number of gap junctions connect the cytoplasm of adjacent cells. Now, when an adjacent cell is excited, action potential results in an influx of a large quantity of positive ions, like sodium and calcium, in that cell. Some of these ions diffuse into the next cell through gap junctions. Entry of positive ions raises membrane potential in the current cell also. When the potential reaches the threshold, voltage-gated sodium channels open. So now the sodium enters in large quantities directly into this cell, causing upstroke. Soon, the L-type of calcium channels also open, causing prolonged entry of calcium. This contributes to a long plateau in the action potential. Thus, an action potential is generated in this cell also. This excitation spreads all over the cell membrane. It stimulates the next cell in the same manner in which this cell got excited. So this is how impulses spread in cardiac muscle. Now let's see how this excitation leads to contraction. Or in other words, how excitation-contraction coupling happens. As we just saw, the newly generated action potential travel along the membrane. As it does so, it also penetrates deeper into the cell by T-tubules. So calcium channels in T-tubules also open. Through them, extracellular calcium enters the cell. This calcium causes the opening of calcium release channels on the sarcoplasmic reticulum as well. So calcium from the sarcoplasmic reticulum also enters the cytoplasm. This is called calcium-induced calcium release. A single release event from a local cluster of calcium release channels is called a calcium spark. Many such sparks inside the cell cause a rise in cytosolic calcium concentration. Now the calcium goes to the contractile filaments and binds with troponin C on thin filaments. From here, the process is similar to that seen in skeletal muscles. Repeated myosin crossbridge cycle causes muscle contraction. So this is the process that links the excitation of the cell to contraction. Now, to initiate relaxation, we have a different set of transport proteins on the membranes. The sodium-potassium ATPase pump removes sodium from the cell. And sodium-calcium exchanger and calcium ATPase pump move calcium out of the cell and back into the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Without calcium, the crossbridge cycle stops and the muscle relaxes. So this was all about excitation-contraction coupling in cardiac muscles. Now let's have a quick summary. Electric activity in one cardiac cell is transmitted to the next by gap junctions at the intercalated discs. The calcium entering from the extracellular fluid causes the release of calcium from the sarcoplasmic reticulum as well. The calcium binds with troponin C and initiates the crossbridge cycle, producing contraction. To terminate the contraction, sodium and calcium are removed from the cytosol, producing relaxation. And most importantly, just like how a cell shares its sodium and calcium with the next cell through gap junctions, you should also share these videos with your friends. If you don't share, you are a very bad cardiomyocyte. Be a good cardiomyocyte and share a dose of excitement with all your friends. I will see you in the next video.